Hey strangers, we're Jake
and Georgia,
a British couple living in Canada trying to see the world.
Just cows everywhere.
So many cows.
Just on the side of the road.
Hello, Georgia.
Hello.
We have arrived.
We have arrived and we've made some new friends.
So we just got to our Airbnb. We'll show you in a little bit. We're also going to do videos for each, aren't we?
Yes.
But we just arrived. We had a little bit of a tour. And yeah, we've got alpacas. We've got some goats. There's chickens roaming around and there's some little sheep just over that way. But like, this is a really cool place to be. We had a bit of a chaotic trip getting into Spokane just because of road layouts and stuff. But we got there. Oh, it's feeding time.
Oh my God.
They're screaming.
Oh my God.
This is so funny.
Oh
no, this is so funny.
I got alpaca snot on me.
Oh no. Crunchy. These little tiny ones. Oh my God, they're running. Oh,
they're so excited.
There's so much going on.
There's such joy. I don't have anything.
Oh. Jeez. This is, they're insane. Oh my God. Okay, we made it in. This one's adorable. I love this one. Hey. Come on then, let's go for a walk. A pack of children. It's this one.
I don't have anything.
Oh. That looks like a goat as well.
I don't know where you get in.
What?
Hi, baby.
I've got all this area. Got all this area that they say women happy to kind of wander around, and the alpacas are coming as they approach from the background. As they would, it's so funny, they're just following us. The host came out and spoke to us, and hello, let us know that we can kind of come around here, have a look at all the animals and stuff, and pet them. We could feed them, obviously, see all the different animals that they've got. And they even said that we could have a snack from their garden, like tomatoes and things, which was really sweet. But we'll show you the Airbnb if we've not already. Now.
Washington. We just got to our Airbnb, which is in fact a school bus. So welcome to our school bus. As you enter, you get the living area. So then moving on back, we've got a lovely kitchen. We've got a sink and real running water. We also have a gas cooktop. and a full oven, which is kind of crazy considering we're in a school bus. So then moving on a little bit back, we've got a full kind of bathroom. And we also have a full-sized fridge freezer. Oh, with an ice tray. Now if we keep on going here, we have our compost toilet. And welcome to our bed for the evening. This is actually a lot bigger than I thought it was gonna be.
The host came out and spoke to us, and hello, let us know that we can kind of come around here, have a look at all the animals and stuff, and pet them. We could feed them, obviously, see all the different animals that they've got. And they even said that we could have a snack from their garden, like tomatoes and things, which was really sweet. They've got goats, alpacas, loads of chickens. They've got more goats. These ones are a bit more aggressive towards the sheep. What are you looking at? So these are about all the lines with the lighting. The fairy lights don't want to work with the camera, so we've got a few black lines. Sorry about that. Okay. So we filmed a little Airbnb video of Schoolie. Now we're going to go into Spokane and see what's going on. And we have something exciting to show you too. So let's go.
We are ready. We've just done a quick little refresh in the bus.
I put jeans on, that's about it.
Now we're going to Spokane.
Let's go to Spokane. Okay. We're in a mall, which we didn't realize we were going to be in a mall, but we came to park and have ended up in a mall. Oh, Pandora. But yeah, we're going down to get something to eat and going to the Riverfront Park, I believe it's called. That's not the way.
The wrong escalator.
We'll reconnect when we know what's going on. Okay, so we just ate at McDaddy's just behind us here, kind of in the mall. I don't know what the mall's called, but the mall. Opposite the Riverfront Park. I had a big McDaddy burger. It had mac and cheese on it. It was so much food. You know,
I feel like I'm going to explode.
Yeah, pulled pork mac and cheese.
Yeah.
We're going to go find out if there's a light show or something. There's a few
the
other things.
The internet says there is.
Google says there is. There's a few other things we were planning on doing, but I don't think we'll have a chance because we're not really here for too long before we go to Yellowstone tomorrow. So let's see what we get up to for the rest of the evening. So this is what we were going to show. There's this really cool light show thing. It's also, we believe, the Mexican Day of Independence. So there's kind of a little bit of like a party going on underneath the big light thing. Yeah, it's super, super dark. But that's okay. Basically, just can't see your face, that's all. So, we don't know what we're going to do for the rest of the night. Probably not much. Probably going to head back to the school bus. As you can see, it's very dark. Not much light anywhere. Ding, ding, ding. So, we will probably call it a night. And see you tomorrow morning.
In the morning, the sun will shine.
We've not done much today, so we'll probably combine tomorrow into today's video, which is fine. So yeah, we'll see you in the morning. Good morning. We've awoken in the bus for the next day. Today's a big driving day. We're going over to Yellowstone. It's a long one. We're going to go through Idaho, the northern part of Idaho, into Montana, and then kind of back out into Idaho on the eastern side. Before we then go into Yellowstone, which is in Wyoming, the next day. So there's a lot of distance to cover today. George has just gone to use the like facilities that are inside the house that they provide, like the showers and stuff like that. There is a shower in here, but I don't know if it works. Just kind of refilmed our Airbnb video because the lighting, like these little light bulbs, and the camera didn't play nicely. Good morning.
Good morning.
How was the bathroom in there?
Lovely.
Yeah? Yeah? Did you see the dogs or anything?
No.
Oh, we'll go see the alpacas before we leave. Nice. Now we have to pack up all our crap. So one thing that we wanted to share last night, but it was a bit too dark for the camera to like show it off. So every single time that we get to a new location, Georgia and I have hand-drawn some stickers for that location. So we have now unlocked the Spokane sticker. There it is. So that'll be available on our Etsy. There'll be links in the bio and everywhere else that we can put a link.
So it's a lovely sticker. Stick it to your laptop, stick it to your car, stick it to your dog, stick it to your mum. Do what you like.
Stick it just, to your mum.
Just look at it.
But yeah, so yeah, there's going to be a sticker for each location that we go to. And here's Spokane's. Look at these alpacas. It's the little baby. Hi, little baby.
Baby.
Hey. 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 Good morning. You going in? Excuse me.
Excuse me. Back.
Come on then. This way. Me. The sheep keep screaming at us, so we're just trying to kind of throw some food over for them, because these goats keep trying to headbutt them. And then the llamas of alpacas, not llamas. We had to free a goat because it was tied up. And we have favourite alpacas, the little black one and this little brown one, because they pay attention to us. Some of them are spitting each other though, so that's not fun. The white ones really shove their heads in and just get aggressive. A gentle neck stroke. Ooh, that's so soft, Georgia, touch this part. The under neck. You had fun at this one?
Mm-hmm.
It's good, there's only like 15 more to go.
And if you wanna stay at Scott and Erica's Airbnb here in Spokane, I will link it in the bottom.
Yeah.
In the bottom.
We'll also we'll write a blog.
Yes.
And yeah, we'll share it on Instagram too.
And with that, we are leaving our school bus Airbnb in Spokane, and we are on to the next at Wonder Camp near Yellowstone.
Near Yellowstone.
Ish.
Big drive ahead.
Big drive ahead.
But first coffee.
Of always.
Of always.
Of always, everyone. That's because I've not had coffee yet. So we've just left Washington State. There's a filter on this. Should I take it off?
Yeah, see what it looks like.
So we've just left Washington State. We are now in Idaho.
Idaho.
Idaho, Udaho.
We all the hoes. In Idaho.
Yes, so we are on the Highway 90, Interstate 90, I don't know how they name it here.
Maybe, I don't know. Anyway, that's what I'm called. Nope. We're on our way,
we're on the same road for 279 miles right now.
So, after, I don't know, it wasn't very long, Georgia had a nap. Probably maybe 30-45 minutes after the last clip, we exited Idaho, and we're now in Montana, which has been very windy so far and very windy roads, but we're still 181 miles until we get to Butte/Buttes, whichever one it is, where we're gonna get some food, and then we still have a bit further to go before we get to our campsite. Back in Idaho. Like, we've come into Montana and back out to Idaho, so.
I get motion sick, so I took some tablets, and they have completely knocked me out. I've had, like, 3 naps so far on this ride. We've only been in the car for 2 hours.
Yeah.
So, I've missed most of Montana, but what I have seen has been very pretty.
It is pretty. We'll show you now.
Okay. Hello. Quick little pit stop at Panera. In Missoula, Montana. Well, lots of traffic. We're just going to nip into Target.
Target!
Because we need to get some food for tonight and tomorrow for breakfast and at lunchtime. So we need to do a bit of a food shop. So we're doing it here, so we don't really have to stop besides like gas. So yes, Missoula, Montana, and then we've got 4 hours to go, which is the same that we've just done. Again, we've also changed time zone since.
Wahoo!
Wahoo! Anyway, all good. So we made it to our glamping site for the evening. We've got ourselves set up. It's late, it's pitch black. We made it here after probably 9 or 10 hours of driving.
Yeah, we set up at 10 o'clock this morning and it is now 10 to 9.
And that's an hour ahead.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's been a long day. Not bad.
No.
The car's doing great and stuff, so that's good. Yeah, Yellowstone tomorrow.
So this is where we stayed last night. This is Wander Camp in Idaho. It's about 25 minutes away from Yellowstone National Park, and pretty much what you see is what you get. You get a bed, you get some chairs, and if you pay a little extra, which we did, you get a heater, and I highly recommend it because, oh boy, it gets cold. So these little guys come attached to your tent when you arrive, and you just gotta boop, pull up, and you've got a little nightlight for the tent. They are pretty good. They lit up the whole tent for us for the whole night, and this one is still going. And they are solar powered. So we're gonna hang these back up outside when we leave. So we booked a king size tent and this was our bed. It was actually very comfortable. And I think my favorite thing was this fluffy white blanket. It is absolutely lovely. But yeah, we made for a good night's sleep. So you do get to park directly next to your tent, so you know that your vehicle and all of your belongings are safe right next to you. We do also have washrooms just down here. There's 6 washrooms, 3 with just a toilet and 3 with showers too. And then just down here you can also see 2 little trailers. Those are going to be the store, and that is open from 8 a.m. to 11 p.m. for anything that you might need. So over here you can see the stores a little bit closer, and also the communal fire pit complete with some twinkle lights, which looked really nice last night. We kind of just hit the hay and watch High School Musical. Together, together, come on, let's have some fun. So they have a bunch of different tent configurations, so you can choose what works best for you. And there are plenty of tents, and it was very reasonably priced. So if you'd like to stay at Wander Camp too, we'll put the link to the website in the description, so make sure you check it out. Oh, hello! Don't mind me. I'm just here at Wander Camp, planning my day to Yellowstone with my handy dandy road trip planner by Wonderful Adventures.
Okay.
In true Jake and Georgia style, we've stopped briefly before we get to Yellowstone to go to the gift shops. I know, it was a case of just like quick throw ourselves into a parking lot.
We love a crap shop.
We're in America, we shouldn't jaywalk. The police station's literally like there.
Okay, back in the car, we have secured the goods. Got a Yellowstone hoodie that's in like the style of a spirit jersey, so it says Yellowstone National Park on the back in like the bubble print. Success.
Sorry.
So we immediately left that tiny little town, I guess you'd say, stretch of stores, and straight away we're now in line to get our pass for the park. There's a huge line.
There is a huge line, and it's moving very slowly.
Yeah, it's like showing up at Disney.
We are now officially inside of Yellowstone National Park. We have our handy dandy guide given to us by the park ranger, and along with our annual pass. And let's go have an adventure today. Just here up ahead, there's some steam like just coming out of the ground.
Ooh.
Ooh. We have made it to the Grand Canyon of Yellowstone. There's the upper falls just out there, you can't really see too well. But, oh, a little chipmunk thing over there. Holy... Oh my god, what the... I was not ex... Ooh. I feel like I'm going to need to film George's reaction to that, because it's not what I was expecting. I don't know why. It's pretty much exactly what that is.
Oh my god, you can hear the water, that's crazy.
Well, you said it was so aggressive when it was hitting the bottom.
The water.
Just go stand over here. So we made it all the way down to the, I think that was the lower falls, because the upper falls is quite far away. Now we just have to hike back up in our not appropriate attire. And then, I can't remember where we said we're going next. We'll find out.
So we're currently driving through Hayden Valley. We did see one bison right on the side of the road coming around a corner. so we didn't get the chance to film it. But just over here, there is a little herd of the guys right over there. So maybe we'll see another one on this side, a little bit closer, but fingers crossed, you know?
So we didn't get to see the bison, there may be more, but we just pulled off at the sulfur, what was it called? The sulfur?
Sulfur.
Yeah, it smells like eggs.
Smells so bad, I can't handle it.
It's interesting. I don't think it's that bad, it smells like, yeah, eggs. Egg sandwiches. There it is, just bubbling away. Crazy, it's all like the hot sulfur underneath the ground just like popping up. And then you can see like the little tiny versions of the little weird pools. Yeah. Nice.
That was a short-lived excursion. It smells so bad. I just couldn't.
She couldn't.
Usually it's Jake that's the sensitive one, but this time it was me.
So we got back in the car and basically just went across the street and we're at the mud volcano. So I assume it's the same, but instead of water it's mud on top. So we shall see what this looks like. So that's what that looks like. Still smells.
Not as bad.
Not as bad.
Dragon's Mouth Springs.
Ooh. Interesting, it sounds like a dragon. Point out if you're a fan of, sorry if it's windy, if you're a fan of the license plate game here in the States,
I love the license plate game.
This place is brilliant.
North Carolina.
Walking through a parking lot, Utah, California, another California, Colorado, Utah, British Columbia. There's so many from literally, like, we've seen Florida's, we've seen Alaska's, we've seen pretty much everything near enough. Oregon. You can kind of see like the colours in it. So this is the, I've already forgotten what it's called.
Something.
West Thumb? This is a geyser. It looks like many geysers. So.
Geyser.
So I don't really know. I don't know how often it goes off, if it goes off. But the guide information sign was basically just saying.
We're all gonna die.
Yeah, it's like, because Yellowstone, if Yellowstone, you know, blows up, the planet blows up. These are the thumb paint pots. There's a bit of colour to them. There's an orange one over there. There's the orange one. And like, that one's kind of more blue. Oh, Georgia. No, you're fine. These ones are a bit more like green, but they have like yellow on sides. I assume that's kind of what it's meaning by paint pots.
Stinky holes.
Thanks for that.
Exactly, you're telling me I can't swim in it?
No, you can't swim in it.
But look at how pretty it is.
I know, but they're really warm.
Mm,
No. This one's collapsing, according to the sign. They are pretty though.
The abyss pool. They've got like a nice ranger-led talk, which we missed, but that's okay. You can see that this one's called Blackpool. That's where I'm from. It's like trickling down and going off into the lake, which I'm sure it's fine. It's probably been doing it for a million years. So we made it to Old Faithful, and as you can tell, it is very, very busy. I just got like a block of ice sized hail hit me in the face. Did not do what it was supposed to do, go like 150 feet or whatever.
It tried.
It gave it a little go. I mean, so.
It didn't try very hard.
No. The storm picked up really quickly. Probably gonna call it a day at Yellowstone.
I've been sat cross leg for so long and now I can't feel my right leg.
But what better time? To share that obviously we arrived in Yellowstone, Georgia, so that means we unlocked our new next sticker. The Yellowstone sticker. It's Old Faithful. That went higher than the actual thing. But that will be available on our Etsy. Please go check it out if you like it. Hand drawn by, I think, me.
Yeah, you did this.
But yeah. Okay, we're gonna probably go get in the car and then sit in traffic to try and leave.
So we saw Old Faithful. He put on a little bit of a show, but he didn't put too much effort into it.
No.
The
wind really picked up though, and like,
yeah, it wrenched the people to the right of the geyser, and they all ran away. It was kind of funny, but
yeah.
We wanted to go to the Grand Prismatic pool, but the parking lot was full, and like parking on the side of the road on both sides was just completely packed, so
there was no way of actually getting to it.
No. So it's something for next time.
Yeah.
And we are now leaving Yellowstone National Park, and there's some bison on the side of the road, so I'm just going to show you that real quick. Oh my god! No way!
Do not
snap
the nose,
please.
Keep moving. Road
trip
for driving. Turn out to the
beach.
They still yell at me!
So that was cool. That made it worth it. So, what did you think of Yellowstone?
I absolutely loved Yellowstone. I'm so glad that we came. It was short and sweet. We only had the one day. I wish we had two. I feel like you could do everything in 2 days.
Everything without like then extending it by going hiking and stuff. Like just go to all the spots and all the kind of like natural attractions.
Yeah.
You could definitely do that in 2 days.
Definitely. We are not hikers. I don't know how much of the first bit Jake filmed at the waterfall, but that 10 minute hike back up I thought I was gonna die.
We're not built for things like that.
No, we're not. So yeah, I think we had a really, really good time.
Definitely.
We definitely made the most of the time that we have.
Yeah.
We saw everything that we wanted to, except for the prismatic, and then we saw the bison with the family and the babies. So yeah.
Yeah. No, it was great.
Now we are on our way to Salt Lake City, and we have something very exciting planned for tomorrow. You're definitely not going to want to miss that one, especially if you were growing up with us in the early 2000s. Little foreshadowing for you.
Yeah. Morning, strangers.
Morning, strangers.
Welcome to Salt Lake City, Utah. That's about all we know so far.
Yeah. they have those spinny things.
They've got some spinny things. But yeah, we just arrived. We just parked up. We spent the morning in the hotel, just kind of doing some editing and refreshing up after a couple nights of Airbnbs.
It was so nice to have a real shower.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, we're going to go grab a coffee and just kind of see where the day takes us. We only have one thing officially kind of planned in today. So, besides that, let's see what we do. Starbucks at the ready. Good to go. There she is. Yeah.
Is that where we're going?
Yeah, I was going to go up the escalator because I'm lazy. So like I said, we're not really sure what we're going to do, so we're currently just wandering around towards Temple Square. I think we're in a mall. So we'll just see what's in the mall and see where we go from here. So I think that's the main kind of temple that you come to see at Salt Lake. It's under scaffolding, so there's that. And then there's the other one. I don't know anything about them, I'm afraid. We can try and find out. We made it to Temple Square. So that was the assembly hall just behind us. Very ornate. I think he said it was finished being built from granite in 1880. Yeah. They just did a worship service. They were about to do a mini version of the service or something. So we kind of just stepped out, but very impressive building.
Perfect.
So a lot of Temple Square is under construction at the moment. This is the Salt Lake Temple. Very famous building, I think, from Salt Lake. Everything that I saw when I was looking it up showed off like this building and everything, so it's a shame that it's under construction, because I think it's quite a good looking building, but it's nice that they're obviously looking after everything. It's the big convention center for the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. I think we're going to go and have a look at the, see if we can go to see the rooftop garden. I think there is a big convention on though, isn't there? We keep seeing people with name tags and flags on the name tags, so maybe, I don't know, potentially Mormons from different countries. Part of the rooftop garden is closed, but you can see they've got some really nice trees and bushes and some little displays at the back, and like views of the mountains and stuff all the way around. And Georgia. I'm not sure if this building is significant, but it's very cool. Yeah, we're climbing this big hill. It's not that big. I believe it's the Capitol, State Capitol building. Quick photo shoot in front of the Capitol Hill. I think it's called Capitol Hill. I saw a sign that said it, so Utah State Capitol Hill. So there's just a bit of a river
from the garden in, or... Oh no, it looks like a pipe might have burst. Uh-oh. Oh no, I'm fully in it. So just across is the, I believe the like head offices of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. So it's a pretty big building, with some big like globes printed in the concrete. It looks really cool. And this is where like Brigham Young actually lived and his offices and everything. It's called the Beehive House, and next door is the Lion House. And this is about a block away. And that park we were just in, it was also part of his residence. Did you say it was three blocks wide,
his land? Residence, like his land, excuse me. His land was three blocks wide and almost three blocks, like, east.
Yeah. And we need to just double check. I think Brigham Young's part of how the Mormons ended up in Salt Lake.
Well, he was the president of the
church. Yeah.
The Beehive House served as Brigham Young's residence, office, and reception area for official visitors. At the time of the house was built, Young was both president of the Latter-day Saints Church and Utah's territorial governor. The Beehive House was designed by Young's brother-in-law, Truman O. Angell. Angell was also the architect for the Lion House and the Salt Lake LDS Temple. The Beehive House features a two-story veranda, an observatory, and a cupola topped with a beehive. In the early 1960s, the Latter-day Saints Church restored the Beehive House to resemble its 1988 appearance.
Okay, it's definitely lunchtime. So we're back in the, I think it's called the City Creek Mall. Very, very nice mall.
Beautiful mall.
Yeah, it's just like the downtown area. It's all kind of blended with like a bit of nature and some fountains and stuff. I think we're trying to get to the Cheesecake Factory. Okay, Cheesecake Factory for lunch. We'll see you when we're full. Lunch successfully consumed. Just have a quick look. I didn't walk in the wall. We're gonna look in the mall, and then I think we're off to start something new. Oh, it's dark.
Oh, it's so dark.
Right, it's time to have a little walk around the mall, which is a very nice mall. And then
we're gonna go start something new.
Yeah. What does that mean? Bye, Salt Lake. It's been fun, had a nice time. Now it's time to do something else. I couldn't think of a better pun.
So we have officially already ended this vlog.
We have.
But we kind of forgot, and it didn't take us very long to forget. Day what, three?
Four. This is the third one.
This is the third one. But for Salt Lake City, like the other destinations that we've had, we do also have a sticker!
Yay!
Yay! This is now available over on our Etsy. That will be linked in the description below. So please go check it out if you like Salt Lake City, if you live in Salt Lake City.
Or if you just like Utah, or if you just like travel stickers. Because some people I've spoken to really, really like them, and they've never been to the places and still want them, so...
So there you go.
There you go. If you want to kind of get a little sticker book made up, there you go.
Sticky, sticky.
Thanks.
Yeah, so go check them out, and we have our other destinations on there too.
Yeah.
So, thanks. Boop.
What was that?
This is the stupidest shit we've ever done.
Where are we?
We're at the home of the wildcats, Jake.
Oh my goodness. East High. Why are we here? Because we're mentally unwell. And we didn't plan the trip around this, but we made sure we were going to stop.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. And apparently, we can go inside.
Oh yeah.
This makes me feel so creepy, but we just walked into the school.
I've never felt more traumatised but excited at the same time.
And we got souvenir maps. So obviously they're used to people. Let's go stand over by the wildcat. So they... This is really weird. They are used to this. Holy shit. They're used to it, so they have a full thing. There's stickers on... There's signs on the windows. There's already got, like, self-guided tour maps. And they have a procedure about, like, buzzing in and stuff like that. So, here we are. And I got a baseball field. It's a shame I don't dance. This is just insane. And the back of the map even tells us where the like key locations are, including like this was where they filmed. What time is it? Welcome to the tour. I'd like to welcome you to my and Georgia's new lockers. This is so stupid. I can't believe you're going on a US road trip and we're just at the high school.
Not a high school. The high school. To get out there, just someone's locker.
Okay, so the room just through there. It was painted green for high school musical 3. Is the like form room of Miss Starbus's class. And then followed by this which is the stairs that you see here were in What Time Is It in High School Musical 2, which on these stairs, Sharpay signs someone's yearbook. I wish she would sign mine, but she's not here. So we're trying not to disturb the kids and the teachers and stuff, because they just finished school. We're allowed to be here. But we're trying to get to the theatre. There's kids in there though. So we don't want
how
to.
How selfish.
Hello.
Tears and Troy. I just Tears and Troy.
So here's Gabriella's locker. Let's go find Troy's. We're coming around these corners. And it's just like, we actually know where these things are.
This is Troy Bolton's locker.
Troy Bolton's locker.
The Troy Bolton.
The Troy Bolton. We're just kind of talking about it. It's interesting. They must have come and been like, can we just use your like logo and your colours and stuff? So we don't have to redecorate the school. And the school's probably like, yeah, she'll pay us something. Now it's like, oh, thank God that they left it. Because we can just recognise everything based on it all being red and a big giant E's everywhere.
So this is the bathroom that Gabriella hides in when Sharpay is looking for her. You know, she like, she kicks one of the doors, she's like, poof, and it opens. And then the scene ends with Gabriella coming out from behind this wall. There is absolutely no way that she would have been able to hide here. I mean, okay. But I mean, this is pretty cool, I guess. I mean, it's just a high school bathroom, but just made it so iconic by that one moment.
Okay, George's big moment to shine. This is where, part of where Gabriella made her way around this school singing that song.
She did.
This is where she sings When There Was Me and You.
Oh no, this kid's stabbing. Oh. She turns around and she does
like a drop thing. Oh, can't wait to put it next to the clip from the film. The children are getting angered. Georgia, we need to go this way for the science lab. Thanks to this excellent guide, room 3130, I believe is on the left, is the science room. You might as well try or knock. I'm so scared.
Hi, sorry.
Did it look cool?
I don't know.
Run away. Some real chaos going on in there. Troy must have scored another basket. I'm very scared to try and open these doors. Oh.
Is it locked?
It's locked. Oh, it's still locked.
It's probably because they're actually in there.
Yeah, and they're like, these freaks are going to try and come in.
Yeah. Oops, sorry.
Gotcha. like we said, we're going to try and respect all the students and stuff as much as possible, so we're not going to try and force our way into the boys' locker room. That sounds terrifying. That.
And illegal.
quite illegal. Okay, we've come all the way from England for this. Welcome to the common room. The tables, the famous tables that have been danced upon. You probably had to replace them. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the early to mid 2000s. Where was this phone in my life?
I'd have that now.
Steal it.
Take away my iPhone, I'll just take that.
Again, don't want to bother the kids, but...
Sorry.
Don't want to bother the kids, but there's the gym. What did you say?
I went through to the volleyball house, because I'm nearly done.
Maybe. Very quickly, because there's still kids in there. Oh, the theatre, preparing for the spring musicale. Okay, so that's us done inside of East High.
Very go Wildcats.
Go Wildcats, very unique experience, very interesting to just wander around a school. There were a lot of the people there doing the same thing.
Yeah.
So, yeah. There
it
go.
Made us feel better when more people arrived that were losers like us.
Yeah. So, but that's not all. Georgia, what time is it?
Seven.
Okay, so we're going to head down to our hotel towards Zion Park, which we'll be at tomorrow. Hey Gingers, good morning.
Good morning.
So we're here in St. George, Utah, southern Utah, at a country club called the Innet Entrada. If you've watched our Instagram stories from when the trip was happening, you will know that this is where they filmed High School Musical 2. Welcome to Lava Springs, everyone. I believe that is where Sharpay has her Star Dazzle Awards. We think this is where they filmed the everyday scene, like the talent show at the end of the movie. And this is the like country club building. There's like members having their breakfast and stuff. It's all very fancy and I don't think we're allowed in. I'm trying a wellness center. I'm just looking for something to eat. Okay. Let's go into the wellness center and see if we recognize anything here. Foiled once again. Ended up in the wrong place.
But we were originally in the right place.
We were. Oh, your head has disappeared with the glowing sun. Yeah, we were in the right place. We have come to the wrong place. We're going back to where we were just before. Quick little breakfast from the snack bar just downstairs in the country club. Very reasonably priced. Once you've paid $600 a night for a room, you can have reasonably priced pancakes. How was breakfast at the snack bar?
Delicious.
Yeah, freshly made pancakes with bacon and eggs and some iced coffee. Okay, let's see where we go from here in Lava Springs, in it and try to... Okay, so we made a little purchase at the golf shop. Can you see it? There you go. And you got a bit of a discount for staying at the hotel part of the country club. They're also doing a bit of construction, we'll show you now. But this is the iconic Gotta Go My Own Way bridge, which we apparently can't use because of the construction, but iconic nevertheless. I think we're going to go try and get ready, maybe go sit by the pool. It's a little bit overcast, but it'll be good. Okay, what are we up to?
We're going to the pool.
Going to the pool.
You know why? It's quite fabulous. Oh, thanks,
We made it. Oh my god, it's the pool. And it definitely looks smaller than in the movie. That's so funny. Hey, lifeguard! The pool definitely looks smaller than in the film. Because they're all doing the like dancing and singing and stuff at the end for all for one. Up there, and it just doesn't look like it's big enough. Oh, there she goes. Okay, swim like Gabriella.
Okay.
I mean, over there it's 8 feet deep.
I know.
I understand the stress.
It's 6 feet here.
You know, right now with you, it's finally starting to feel like summer.
Yeah, it is.
Water bugs are back.
Look, Mr. Fulton. This was my idea. She had nothing to do with it.
I generously overlooked your previous brake violation, but then came the golf course jaunt. 2 strikes. Don't get a third. Out of the pool!
I like what I see. I like it a lot. Is it absolutely fabulous? Fabulous, fabulous. Absolutely. Not
fabulous.
What was that, sorry?
That was absolutely fabulous.
Fabulous. So yeah, we're done at the pool and sadly done at the hotel. We just need to go get changed and then we're done so.
Welcome to the Innocent Trotter, or better known as Lava Springs. So this is our room. Sorry, I'm in a bit of shock. So here, as we enter, we have a lovely little kitchenette. Nice little breakfast bar area over here. And a desk, just in case. And some faux grass, just in case you needed to touch some and bring yourself back to reality. This here is our beautiful bed that we have not yet gotten into or ruined or sat on. Here we have possibly the softest robe I have ever felt. It's stunning. Moving over to the living area, equipped with plush leather seats for you to lounge and relax. A flat screen TV, what I may be most excited for, the fireplace in the room. So pretty much everything in the room is controlled by these little panels on the wall. So anything I need, shades down, and down they go. And now, I'm going to take you into the most phenomenal bathroom that I have ever seen. We'll ignore the toilet, that's neither here nor there. But this tub is a jacuzzi tub that I am very excited to use. We also have Isenhouse sinks out of the way, doing my makeup in the morning. Looking at myself in disbelief. Here we have a shower complete with the Innocent Trotter logo. And coming out of the bathroom, we have a nice, very big closet. And where do we put our car? Well, in our own private garage, of course. And surely there can't be more. We have our own private patio that I am sure we will be making good use of. So that's a quick look at our room here at the Innocent Trotter.
bye room. It's been wonderful. It's been so much fun. We've had a great time. But now it's time for Zion.
Hello to summer.
And with that, we have left the Inner Intrada, aka Lava Springs.
Lava Springs.
And we are on our way to Zion. I've just said to Jake, I think that was the best, like, 12 hours of my life. I am now a country club girly, and I've decided that that is where I want to retire. So, nothing more, nothing less.
Made it into Zion, showed our little annual pass and everything. The parking lot is completely full. There were signs saying you had to park in the town beforehand and get a bus. We don't have time. We're kind of just driving through, aren't we?
Yeah.
So we've just driven around for a little bit, and there's some spaces for like 15 minute parking. So we've got 15 minutes. Very busy in the tourist centre, obviously the visitor centre. Well, we've got some postcards, and we'll have a little wander. A little wander, because we've only got 15 minutes.
Okay, $3 spent, and some postcards obtained. We're going to take some quick photos, and then I think we're back in the car. We're going to basically just drive through Zion, and pull over when we can, and stuff like that. But yeah, parking lot was chaos.
We would absolutely love to spend more time here and stuff, and obviously the parking stuff's its own thing. If we didn't spend as long as the hotel, then we'd have been able to come spend a bit more time, but the hotel was really big and important for us, and it was expensive, so we had to make the most of it. And we're going to drive through Zion at least, so we're going to actually get to see things. But it's absolutely stunning, and this whole trip has been a lot of like, we'll stop everywhere once, see it, and anywhere that we want to go back to, we'll make sure we go back to. And I already think we've only driven into Zion for like 25 minutes, and I feel like we're probably going to be back. Oh, there's one of the like double buses. You can't really see it very well, but the little double buses that you can go on to take you everywhere else in the park. If you've been watching our videos of this trip so far, you'll know that every time we get to somewhere pretty exciting, we have something exciting to show you. So Zion is no exception. So without further ado.
Ta-da! Ta-da!
This is the Zion National Park sticker that we drew. It's a really fun one. As with the other ones, it'll now be available on Etsy, so please feel free to go check it out if you like travel stickers like we do. And we drew it ourselves, so any purchase of a sticker helps fund these sort of things. So thank you.
Officially left Zion National Park. We did just drive through it. We didn't do any hikes this time, but we are now on our way to Horseshoe Bend.
Yes,
we should get there around about golden hour, which is really nice. And yeah, super excited. Welcome to Arizona.
So we're just arriving at the Horseshoe Bend.
Indeed.
Good thing to know if you're planning on coming here. It is $10 per car to get in, which is something we did not know.
Nope.
It
doesn't seem like you can use your annual pass or anything like that for national parks. It seems like it's a separate
thing.
Yeah. So it's its own thing. For whatever reason.
Yeah. So we're gonna head on in once we get around, you know, this whole line.
Okay, what did you say it was? About a mile and a half?
Yeah.
Okay, it's not too bad.
Yeah.
It's pretty busy. But you can, I don't...
Pretty busy for 5 p.m.
I don't know if it's frowned upon, but everyone else is just like walking off the path. Then they're just kind of like, don't fall off. It's very high up and very scary. I don't think this is really doing it justice how big it is. Boat down there.
There is?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. I know, that's cool.
Yeah.
There's some kayaks.
Oh. Okay, we've been and we've seen. Now it's time to do the little trek back, and I think we're going to Flagstaff, aren't we, first?
Yes.
Flagstaff, Arizona.
Flagstaff, Arizona. Horseshoe Bend, and we are on our way to Flagstaff, Arizona.
Yes. As we have been for the last 10 years, apparently. It's been such a long drive.
Time doesn't change.
Every time we look at the time on the navigation, it just doesn't, it hasn't moved.
It's not.
We're just stopping in Flagstaff for something to eat and then fuel before potentially about 50 minutes of driving to get to our Airbnb just near the Grand Canyon.
Yes, and then leading into that, we are going to the Grand Canyon tomorrow. So make sure you come back for that video. And then tomorrow we will also be driving to Las Vegas.
Las Vegas, baby!
Vegas, baby! Good morning.
Hey, strangers. Good morning.
So here's our accommodation from last night.
Yeah. It wasn't the best one. It was fine, and it did what it needed to do. Yeah. There were just some things that weren't, like the heater wasn't working and stuff.
Yeah.
And it was pretty tough to get to.
Yeah.
So we're not really going to showcase it too much, and we're not really going to, promote it.
We're not going to do a video on this one.
No, but it was fine, and like it was comfortable and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. You know, it is what it is. That's fine.
Yeah. But now we are on our way to the Grand Canyon.
That's right, welcome back to the next episode of our West Coast road trip. Today we have made our way down towards the Grand Canyon. Yesterday we were at Zion National Park, we drove all the way around the big hole in the ground, and now we're about to go see it for the first time.
So we've made it to the Grand Canyon, we're just waiting to go in now.
Yeah.
And I think this is covered by our America the Beautiful annual pass.
We hope so.
But we'll let you know.
Because we paid for it. Well. If not, $35.
Yeah.
Credit and debit open. In fact, confirm that the annual pass, the America the Beautiful pass, was accepted. So now you know when you come to the Grand Canyon. Here we go, Grand Canyon.
Hole
in the ground. I mean, you can just tell it's massive just by walking up to it.
at it. That's insane. I like that people bring their dogs so the dogs get to see too. And the dog's just like, I don't know what this is. Holy. That's so far down. Wow, that's immense. Pretty cool, we got some nice photos. Ooh. But the park officially only opened like maybe 30 minutes ago. Yeah, there's people everywhere. Made our way down to the visitor center, we believe. So we'll see what there is to see, and I assume there will be purchases made in a gift shop. Inside the park store here at the visitor center, they've got some cool stuff. They've got a spirit jersey, which is pretty cool. Okay, so if you've been watching the videos so far, each location that we go to, we've released a sticker, and the Grand Canyon is no exception. So we would like to show you the Grand Canyon sticker. Yay! We both did this one on Procreate, and we did a little bird, and been a fun one. I like this one. It's a fun one. I like all of them, but this is a fun one. Yeah, it will be available on Etsy right now, so please go and check it out. And yeah, supporting the stickers means supporting our adventures, so thank you very much.
Thank you.
It is now time to... Oh, she's gone. It is now time to say goodbye to the Grand Canyon as we make our way over to...
Las Vegas.
Las Vegas. But first, Starbucks, of course.
Oh, yes.
And because it's America, there's a Starbucks just at the entrance to the Grand Canyon. Now we're turning on to
US
93 towards Vegas. We've got about 108 miles, about an hour and 40 minutes. We'll need to just stop and get some fuel, but we will be getting there about 3 p.m., which is pretty decent.
It is good. And we'll have like near enough 3 days in Vegas, which is great.
And we'll be checking into the Paris Hotel.
Hotel Paris.
Bonjour.
Bonjour, bonjour, baguette.
Welcome to Las Vegas.
Yeehaw.
After some minor meltdowns, we've made it to our hotel in Paris. Not in Paris, the Paris. Oh wow, it's very dark. This camera does not like darkness. We've come to the Rainforest Cafe.
Fine dining.
Fine dining, just for a quick drink and some nachos, and then we're gonna explore everything else. We're just very overwhelmed by the strip right now. Can't wait for the next thunderstorm. Our first thunderstorm of the evening. We are currently leaving during our third thunderstorm, which means we've been here too long. Sufficiently buzzed off of our giant hurricanes. Can't wait to go to Bubba Gump and Margaritaville. Anyway, first...
We could go to Bubba Gump.
Okay, we made our way into the Cosmopolitan, just across from everyone's favourite Rainforest Cafe. Got ourselves a Fat Tuesdays, which is alcoholic slushies, a blue raspberry... And yeah, we're making our way underneath the chandelier bar.
And don't know, some ladies with their breasts out tried to take a photo with Georgia. So that's how our evening's going so far.
A crisp dollar bill.
I've never betted before.
Betted.
Or gambled. What do I do? Spin.
Quick spin.
That was a waste of a dollar.
How much have you won? 15 cents!
It was the 15 cents someone had left as credit.
Where are you going to spend it?
Nowhere. We live in an inflation times. Nowhere is worth 15 cents.
It's cooled off significantly. Yeah, we've just been in the Cosmopolitan. And now I think we're going to go next door. I think it's the Bellagio. Unfortunately, because F1 is coming to Vegas in November.
I am disgusted.
Vegas is hosting F1 in November. They have blocked off, I believe, all of the Bellagio fountain to put stands on it so people can watch. So there'll be no Bellagio fountain show, which is extremely depressing because that's what I wanted to watch. But that's okay. We'll go look at the hotel and then... probably find another Fat Tuesday. Woo! It's dripped blue on me. Making our way to the Bellagio. We do love a theme. Welcome to the Bellagio. We're going to go look at the Bellagio Conservatory, which has just reopened with, I believe, was it the harvest?
The harvest
theme. It changes four times a year, so seasonally, I assume. So let's go check this out. I also just saw the fountains going off, so you just can't see them in front of the Bellagio like you normally would on the strip, but you can see them from anywhere else you have a view. It's adorable.
It's my leg pocket.
Yeah. I think he's got like a very loose Cinderella theme. It's lovely.
So the Bellagio Harvest Conservatory, I have never felt more at peace, and like this is a room full of people and I have major like social anxiety and I have never felt so calm. Like I'm
it's
so beautiful,
we'll
and like
come back tomorrow too.
The scents and the music and the colors and the entire like atmosphere is so amazing. And I don't think I'll ever get over this, to be honest.
Look at this chocolate fountain. It's coming down from all these little pedestals, or whatever you would call those. But where does it go?
To my heart.
To your heart. To your arteries. We've returned already. It's
So George's favourite place ever.
I think it is.
Well, so the Bellagio fountains are on.
They are on, evidently.
I can't really see you, but yeah.
Evidently, TikTok lied.
No, TikTok, I think, said you just can't see it from the strip, and I misunderstood.
Look, TikTok said that they would.
Well, yeah. How would you like a crisp $1 bill? Ready for huff and puffs. Wait, just click play. I don't know. Maybe now click play?
Just took my money.
That was successful. We've wandered into some of the hotels, and I think we're calling it a night just because we've been up early at the Grand Canyon.
Yeah, we got up at like, ooh, what, 6?
Yeah, I think I've been awake since 5. It's been a long day, so we'll see. Okay, back to Le Paris.
Le Paris.
Hotel.
Le Chateau et Paris.
Et Casino. And I think we're going to get a vending machine cake.
Yeah, boy.
From the cake boss. So one of the last things we'll be partaking in here in Vegas for the night, because we're here for another one night. The Cake Boss cake shop vending machine.
Your cake is coming
right out.
Oh my god, please give it
to me. Nice.
Cheers to that one, the smell of it.
Vegas, baby! Time for breakfast at Brioche. Okay, Brioche is acquired.
Mm-hmm.
A bit of coffee, and we can just sit by the pool beneath the Eiffel Tower before we go for a walk and wander around elsewhere. Here we go, back onto the strip. I'm gonna go wander to a mall, see where we end up. Yeah, just wandered through the area, and I think we might be at the New York almost, so we'll go see what's going on in there. So we got to the New York, I think the MGM, yeah, just across, is like a Coke store and stuff, and Hard Rock, so we're gonna, I think we'll see what's inside the New York.
It's getting hot.
Yeah, it's 10 a.m, and it's currently, it's only 14 degrees apparently. All right then. Okay, inside the New York, hello. There's the roller coaster up there. Don't know how you get on it, I believe it's like $30 to actually ride, so maybe we won't be doing that, but it's similar to our hotel, like the outdoor-indoor situation. Game over. I don't even know how you do these. So we looked in New York, had a little wander, went into the Hershey chocolate world. Now I think we're going into the MGM Grand. Okay, $5 on black. Oh, it went on black. I don't know what this means. We just won a bet! Okay, we put 5 on red this time. So we're not losing anything this time because we just won this 5. And if we lose,
it's
we can walk away.
Yeah.
We don't have a gambling.
Take our 5 back, yeah.
And we'll go buy a drink.
Yeah. Right. Can't buy a drink for 5.
No, that's true.
Come on, red.
It was on red!
When did we become good at gambling? Oh, red.
That's okay.
Time to leave before we have a problem.
Number two and number six are the front runners.
Go on, number six.
Go on, number six. No.
Oh, no, number five.
Go
on,
number six.
Oh, number six is tired.
No, he's not.
Oh. Oh, no.
I'm not good at this.
Boo. Six came last.
Ancient dragon. It did come last. You loser.
Stupid horse.
Okay, so we've done a couple shops and just some wandering around like the MGM. We're back on the strip. We're going to get something to eat and then we're going to just go back to the room because we're in like leggings and long sleeves because it was cooler when we left. And we'll go from there again.
Okay, so Chick-fil-A has been consumed. FaceTimes have been had. And now we're ready to go out for the afternoon. And then we've also just booked tickets to go see O, which is Cirque du Soleil, over at the Bellagio across the street.
It's
like a circus-y, acrobatic-y show, but with water. But I've heard it's very good. So we're going to go and see what we want to see, maybe go to the Venetian, and then make our way over there this evening. We're on the hunt, aren't we?
We are on the hunt.
For another Fat Tuesdays. Well, we don't know where they are. In-N-Out Burger. Okay, we got the Fat Tuesdays. Has leaked quite a bit, but that's okay. And I think we're going into the Venetian. Treasure Island, just across the road. Did you like the Venetian?
Yeah, I thought that it was going to be a lot bigger.
It's pretty big, but I thought the canal thing was going to be bigger.
Yeah, that's it. Like, it always looks and seems like it'll
be
bigger than
and it was just a bit of a stretch. It was like a hallway.
Yeah, pretty much.
So, yeah, but it's a fortune
to go on it.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the actual hotel itself is massive.
It's very beautiful.
We've walked through the whole thing. We've only just found where the lobby is, which is here. But, yeah, no, nice. It was more of a shopping mall, wasn't it?
Literally.
Which is cool. Anyway, Treasure Island.
Treasure Island.
An additional Fat Tuesdays and some purchases made in the mall. We've still yet to make it to the Treasure Island, so we're gonna head there now. This whole area, where the ship is and stuff, used to be like a big lagoon. And they used to do a big pirate show here, I believe, if I remember correctly. And they had a pirate ship that completely like submerged itself, and like the pirates went down with it. I think it came back up.
What I have come to learn in our four-year relationship is that Jake knows a little bit about everything.
I'm a fountain of knowledge, but nothing important.
It's always useless.
If you want to know anything about the operations of Walt Disney World Resort in Florida...
This is your man.
I probably know.
Yeah.
And if I don't know, I can probably work it out.
Yeah.
It's getting cloudy. Oh, she's off. An evening upon the strip, Georgia. A lot of copyright music, but we got another Fat Tuesdays.
And now we're going to try and find In-N-Out Burger, which I've never tried before. And I'm very excited to go try. Is that a robot bar? It is a robot bar. Oh my god, In-N-Out Burger, thank god. I'm so bored of walking.
Yeah, that's fair. So there's the burgers. We got two double doubles, and then we also got a animal fries.
Yeah.
Which is just like their normal fries with like a load of stuff on top. And we've had set out on the wall of the fountain because the inside was full. So we'll eat this. I've been so excited to try it now. So we'll give it a go.
Okay, we won our roommate $40. No, it's our turn to win,
no,
big.
We're gonna lose.
Well, if you done $10 on black, okay. Black.
It's black. Nice.
Yes.
Nice.
Go team. Okay, we'll do this until we're a failure. We made our way over to the Bellagio. We won a tiny bit of money in the Flamingo Casino. We're over at the Bellagio.
Well, we doubled our money, actually.
We did.
In
so
the Flamingo.
We put in 20, we got out 40. So that's pretty nice. And we did the
big.
Same. We did the same for our roommate too, so.
Vegas, baby!
Clearly, we're gamblers. We're going to see Cirque du Soleil's O, which will be really cool. I assume they won't let us film, but we'll describe after we've seen it. Oh, the O Theatre Gallery. This is the one. Okay, not that you can see Georgia. Look at me. No, you can't see you. So we've just made our way into O, which is Cirque du Soleil here at the Bellagio. That's giving me. Oh, spooky lighting. So here she is, here's Georgia. So we're in like a row of seats, which is interesting. They were the cheapest that we could get today. I'm very grateful for the fact that we didn't have to pay for them either. Thank you, mother and father. But yeah, we've got a perfect view of the stage. Come on in. We are starting our last morning in Vegas, obviously making our way to Starbucks, which will have a long line but will be worth it. Whilst we wait for our mobile order to Starbucks,
George is back on the slots or whatever this is, roulette. No, well, you put money in a slot. What are we doing? $5 on black and then we're going to walk away.
Just killing time.
Oh, so very close. Oh well. Starbucks acquired. Starting to rain, so we're going to find somewhere to go inside and try and get something to eat somewhere too. Okay, sausage and egg and... Oh, it's very flickery. Sausage, egg and something.
Baby vomit.
Bechamel. Crepes from the New York Hotel. We'll be back after we've eaten. Regrets. You ready?
That looks... Oh, it's hot.
Yeah, we got the one with the normal Hershey's chocolate on it. You could have also got a Reese's Peanut Butter Cup.
Kit Kat.
They had some other ones. It looked like they had like a mint peanut butter cup and maybe like a red, like a strawberry Kit Kat too. We went classic and yeah, we didn't need it.
No, not at all.
But here we are. We've made it.
Say that again.
Mistakes we've been made.
It's gonna drip.
It is gonna drip.
It's gonna drip at this end. And guess what we forgot to do?
Napkins!
Oh no.
Georgia, take it quick. It does say get ready to, like, ready, set, smush, so.
How are you supposed to eat this?
I don't know. So. Last bite. Down in one.
It was good.
It was good? Mm. Nice. And I only had, like, two bites.
I'm gonna throw up later.
Quite possibly. So we've been at the premium outlets here in Vegas, the north one, for the last few hours. Just wandering around the shops and stuff like that. Not much else happened today. We were leaving Vegas for the most part. We kind of ran out of time to do some other stuff like the Fremont Street. But I mean, there's always next time. We'll definitely be back to Vegas. So there's that. So we're just leaving Nevada. We did forget to do something. Everywhere that we go on the strip, we're showing off little stickers that we've designed and drawn and stuff, and we forgot to show them from Vegas. Ba-ba-da-ba! Yay! Obviously, it's the Welcome to Fabulous Las Vegas sticker. We tried to go to the sign yesterday and it just didn't work out, but
yeah,
there's the sticker. Enjoy the rest of the video. The link to it for the Etsy will be in the description.
So we are now leaving Las Vegas. Behind schedule, as usual.
Massively.
Usually. We should be at our next Airbnb in about 2 hours, probably. Gonna stop in the town of Perump to get something to eat. And yeah, that was our adventures in Las Vegas, Nevada.
Good morning, strangers.
Good morning.
Welcome to, I think this is technically classed as the desert. here in Nevada, we're just near the town of Pahrump, which is about an hour from Vegas. We've just checked out of our Airbnb, which we will give you a little tour of right now.
Welcome to our stargazing pod here in Pahrump, Nevada, just about an hour away from Las Vegas, and this is where we spent the night last night. So as you get in, you have a lovely little picnic bench to dine. Our lovely Airbnb host did provide a telescope for us. Unfortunately, neither of us knows how to use a telescope, but we still had a good time stargazing nonetheless.
You step on in, and straight away we've got a lovely queen bed, two bedside tables, and the host did also supply us with fans which double as a light. And I can see why he provided fans and not a heater in the middle of September, because it's hot right now. There's also a window here just in case you need any fresh air in the night. Does open, of course. So the bathroom's facilities are a porta potty and a pump sink. To be honest, I think it's the cleanest porta potty I have ever used in my life. So good job to our Airbnb host Charles. Kind of what you see is what you get, but look at the beautiful scenery around. It is also fully surrounded by a privacy screen here, which you can close up completely using these bungee cords and just attaching them to the post over there. So the road to get here was a bumpy one. We drive a Nissan Kicks that we have well and truly abused on this road trip. And the road to the glamping site was a 2.5 mile dirt, rocky road with rocks. So if you plan on coming here, we're going to leave the link in the description below. If you plan on coming here, just keep that in mind. If you have a smaller vehicle, you might struggle. So that's our Airbnb here in Peru. So the plan today is to get some coffee, of course.
Yep.
And then we have a long, long drive ahead of us to get into California and head towards Yosemite. Yee-haw. And there we have it, 25 minutes later.
2 miles covered.
2.5 miles covered in 25 minutes.
Oof.
We are back to a real road.
Yay.
Yay!
Now it's time for Starbucks.
Yay! So, as with our other destinations on this trip, we do also have a sticker for what should have been today.
Yeah, so it's not a sticker from Pahrump, Nevada.
No.
It's just next to us here, through that window, a couple miles away, is Death Valley National Park. When Hurricane Hillary, I think it was called, came through, it messed it up real bad.
It's saying online that they don't expect to open until late 2025.
Death Valley National Park still closed after heavy rain and flash flooding nearly 2 weeks ago.
Death Valley is one of the hottest places on Earth. It is not supposed to look like this.
That is a year's worth of rain in one day.
Yeah, I think it pretty much just destroyed the roads and everything. So yeah, mm-hmm. So the park's closed. We were gonna drive through it to then carry on to Yosemite. Plans have changed. We're now gonna be in Nevada for most of today. But yeah, da-da-da-da-da. We still had a sticker.
Yes, we still done it. Yeah.
I think we'd drawn it, and by the time we'd ordered the stickers to come in, the hurricane happened and stuff.
So. Yeah.
But yeah, there's our sticker for Death Valley and the sticker for today. Yeah, please go check it out on it, see what all the other ones that have already been released.
Yeah, that'd be great. Thanks.
Get that signed photo on the way in, because it was on a bridge, but
we'll get on the way out.
So we're just leaving Nevada, There's Nevada. Here's California.
Put your hands up. Like, we are now leaving the desert behind and we are heading into the forest and the mountains of Northern California.
Okay, so we're about 3 hours away from the Airbnb. We're on the other side of Yosemite from it right now. So we're going to drive through Yosemite just to kind of look at it. And then tomorrow we're back into Yosemite.
We didn't want
to
be friends.
Oh, just trying to go pet a dog. We've just stopped in this little town. I don't even know what it's called. Lee something or other. Just went to a little diner. And now we're going to head back on the road for the next couple hours. And we'll see you probably in Yosemite.
We're still about an hour and 30 away from the Airbnb, but we had to stop and take a photo of this.
See, we're just going to the Airbnb now. These two deer were just chilling in the road, the little path.
Of course, we're on another dirt road.
Of course, another dirt road.
Once again.
Just arrived at the Airbnb up the classic bumpy road. It's very adorable. We did notice camera probably can't see it. There's a llama just sat over there. So we'll have to become friends with the llama. It's also first thing in the morning.
It is. It's not even 8 yet. So as you enter through the main doors of the little log cabin, you'll see the bed straight away. Very on theme. Eat your heart out, Disney. We also have this couch that I assume could probably be turned into a sofa bed. It looks like it's one that just like lays flat. And then through here, we've actually got like a really beautiful sink. I think this is like my favorite sink.
which is a weird thing to say, but I mean, it's just pretty sick. And we also had a fully functional working shower in the room, which was a lovely little treat after the last few days. We're here in late September. We do have plenty of blankets available, but if you do run warm, there is an AC unit here, which is controlled by this remote, so you don't even have to get out of bed. And if you come when it's a little cooler out, we do also have this faux fire heater. And then here we do have a Keurig machine, which is very nice, equipped with a bunch of K-pods with different styles of coffee and tea. We also have a microwave, just in case, and a TV that we didn't even get to use in last night. We also have this cool little fridge freezer. So on this side, we've got the fridge. They filled up a Brita for us, and we've got some Coffee Mate and Stevia in there, and then a freezer. So heading outside, we have this lovely little deck area with some lounge chairs. Just behind Jake here, we do have a little breakfast bar, which I imagine would be so cute to have your breakfast at if we had time. We also have this deck area, which is pretty cute. Got a little dining table here, two chairs, a festive board, and of course,
and now for everyone's favourite Airbnb feature, the barnyard animals. Oh my god, I can see the pigs. So we did get here pretty late last night, it was already going dark, but they do have a bunch of wildlife and animals that you can take a look at.
Oh. Uh oh. Uh oh. Little snorty boy. Oh, it sneezed on me.
Yosemite National Park.
Good morning.
Where we're going to be spending most of our day today. We do have a tour booked. Is it the Yosemite ground tour?
Yeah, it kind of goes to like some of the hot spots of the park, and it starts at the Yosemite Valley Lodge. So I believe it's like a hotel.
Yeah, so hopefully that means that we'll get to see all of the must-sees in Yosemite. As with everything, we are on a very limited time scale.
Yeah.
So come along and see what we get up to.
Hello, we've exited the vehicle, parked up at Yosemite Valley Lodge. We just need to go and get our tour tickets and, I don't know.
Wait for the bus.
Wait for the bus. I think it's kind of like a quirky little tram, I think. So, Should be an interesting one. What's the temperature right now?
I don't know, like 7?
About 7 degrees, and yesterday was 30.
Yeah, it's a big change.
It's quite a big jump. So it is definitely a jackets and pants day. Okay, so this is the sort of truck thing that we're getting on. It's just like a big open trailer with seats and just a truck pulling it. We just picked up our tickets for the tour just in the front desk of the hotel, and now we're just going to have a little bit of a wander for the next 45 minutes or so until we're ready to board.
Make sure everybody's super safe by please staying seated the entire time the tram is in motion. If you look again, front and center, but to the left, there's a section called the heart in the rock.
Here we are. Stop one of two. Sorry, not step because the step broke. So.
Step isn't working.
No. This was Valley View. This is where she falls in the river. Made a stop at the tunnel view. Stop. Stop. Stop for something to eat. Got some chicken sandwiches, and then I think we might have a little tiny hike to the falls. Okay, how was lunch?
Really good, actually.
Yeah, from the quick service place at the Yosemite Valley Lodge.
The base camp.
What do you think of the tour?
I really enjoyed the tour.
Yeah.
Our ranger was really nice. She made a few jokes. It was a little bit. Jungle cruisey vibes.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was really, really nice. I feel like we saw a lot of things and stopped at places that we wouldn't have if we'd have driven on our own. And we learned a lot. So koyas in Yosemite aren't even like toddlers yet in respect to fully grown trees. So they were planted 120 years ago, I think she said, but it takes 800 years for them to become fully grown.
Yeah, I agree. The tour was really good. It was about 2 hours long. I think there were a couple other options. Some of them weren't running all year, some of them were. And then in not too long, this is going to become like a bus tour rather than an open air tram. But it was very good. Would recommend it. It was about 40 US each. And yeah, I don't know. Just check it out. I think it was on the website, so if I remember, we'll put it in the description. Now we're going to do the little hike to Yosemite Falls.
Yes.
And Georgia also just said, if you've only got a day here like we do, the tour was nice because you learnt a lot. We could have stopped all the places that it stopped, but we weren't doing because we don't have time, so good value. Thank you.
There she is. And what's that in your hand?
Oh, this is our sticker.
From where?
From our shop.
No. Where can people get this sticker?
At our shop.
Where's that?
At the internet.
It's linked in the description.
It is.
Yeah, or you can get to it from our website. Also linked in the description. Oh, you can't see.
So we're now going to be leaving Yosemite. I've had a really nice time. Yeah?
Me too.
Good. We're now heading to our next location of San Francisco.
San Francisco.
There you go, a little song for it. And this will be one of the next ones that we spend a couple, like a day and a half there. So, should be good. Let's do a big old drive. Ooh.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to a new video, a new day here in San Francisco in California.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. So our first time here. We got in last night at the end of the video from the other one, and we had a little stroll around, and now we're heading off into the city. We're actually staying over in Oakland, and we should be getting a ferry across, but this route looks like it's closed, so we'll have to go a different way. Ferry's on its way. It's time to go on a ferry. Doot doot. Okay, we've made it over, Georgia. Welcome to San Francisco.
Thank you.
We've got a few things to do today. One of them is we could probably do with a snack.
Yeah.
Quick stop in this Paris Baguette bakery before we keep walking. Made it to Union Square. Just gonna go to Macy's and have a little walk and find a bathroom. Okay, so we made it to Union Square. We don't really know what else there is here, so I guess we'll find out. We keep trying to understand the classic San Francisco cable cars. They don't make sense.
It's not working.
They don't seem to be working today. So we're gonna walk, see if we see one. Once we've seen one, I think we have a better chance of being able to get on one, but we haven't even seen one today, so.
No.
They're just such big hills. Found one. Climbing Mount Everest. Also, we were googling the weather. We were googling what you should wear in San Francisco. It was cloudy, it was foggy.
It was cold.
It was nippy. We brought jackets, we're in hoodies, we're in jeans, and a holy guacamole. The sun, she is a beating. And now we get to climb mountains to go see things.
It's just like San Francisco, you know, it's always cold. It's always windy. Where's the cold?
Not today.
Where's the wind?
After hiking down the hill, we've made our way down to the piers. We're going to try and check out Pier 39. I think that's it. And Fisherman's Wharf. We've made it to the touristy area, which
our
is
safe zone.
Our safe zone. There's no hills in tourist locations.
Got to keep them tourists happy and spending money.
Yeah, but here we go. We're at Pier 39, touristy area. They've got an aquarium and a hard rock, and crap shops, as we like to affectionately call them. Oh my god, I just said there's bubble gump and there's a sign for it right there. Yes, on the pier. Just had to stop very quickly to get a t-shirt because I was about to die of sweatiness. And yeah, let's go get something to eat. So there's, I think, Alcatraz. And the Golden Gate Bridge is over there somewhere. Randomly, there is perfect blue skies over here. And then just fog. Oh, I can hear him. Where are we? Oh, she's eating a cherry.
We're at Bubba Gump's.
Yeah? We'll just get a drink though.
Yeah.
Please don't yell at us.
Yeah,
for...
don't yell at us for eating like a chain fish restaurant no. in San Francisco.
We're gonna just actually go get it. Yeah. We're gonna go get real stuff, but we needed the good stuff first.
Oh yeah. So we just finished up at Bubba Gump's. We had just a few drinks.
Yeah.
And then we are gonna adventure a little bit further to the Fisherman's Wharf.
Yeah, I think we're gonna try and stop at Bodine. Bodine is a San Francisco like bakery, but they do clam chowder in a bread bowl. So when in San Francisco, do as the San Franciscans do.
San Franciscans. Oh my god, smell that bread.
What did you say?
Smell that bread.
See the little bakery. Okay, here we are at Boudin's. Boudine, whatever it's called. Here we have the chili and cheese bread bowl. And Georgia got the crab chowder. Very delicious. These are massive. Okay, so what did you have? The crab chowder? Crab chowder. How was it?
It was okay. It was pretty good. Yeah.
Yeah. In the bread bowl, obviously.
Yeah.
I had the beef. What was it? Beef chili. That was really good.
Yeah. Jake's was better.
Yeah. That's okay though.
Yeah.
Okay. Wandering around Fisherman's Wharf, and then I don't know what else we're gonna do. We'll find out. Oh, Giardelli's is this way actually. The Ooh. Chocolate place. Cannot wait. Okay, we're making our way to Georgia.
Sorry.
We're making our way to. The Giardelli factory / shop / experience. It wasn't very clear online what you can do here, but Giardelli is an American chocolate company. Very, very lovely chocolate. If you've been to Orlando and to Disney Springs, they give out free little chocolate squares. They are beautiful, aren't they?
Mm-hmm. Should we go wall sit? Should we go wall sit?
The Giardelli chocolate experience. I don't really know what this is. I tried googling it and it didn't make sense, so let's find out. as George is just in the sea, she's about to get very wet. As with every location on the trip, we have released a sticker. San Francisco is no exception. So without further ado, where the Golden Gate Bridge is technically slowly revealing itself with the clouds, I introduce to you the San Francisco sticker. Which of course had to have the Golden Gate Bridge on it. It says San Francisco in California, but this sticker along with all of our other ones will be available on Etsy. Link will be in the description. Thank you so much for checking them out. And every time you buy a sticker, it supports our travels somehow. So thanks so much. Grabbed a little ocean beach sundae for the ocean beach. It's like a caramelly, milk chocolatey thing. Should be very good. Ghiardelli's at its finest. There's Alcatraz. And we were just talking about earlier, this trip is to decide other places to visit, isn't it?
It is a taster.
Yeah, everything's a taster. And we were planning on going to all the different places and then finding out where we wanted to go back to. We've already decided like Zion would be a great place to go back to, and Vegas as well. San Francisco's up there. As one of the key places to come back to. Obviously we haven't been able to Alcatraz today. We didn't know if we had time or, you know, the money to do it. But it's been a really great day. Not that it's done. And the Walt Disney Family Museum we were going to be going to tomorrow, unfortunately, is closed Tuesdays and Wednesdays, which are the only 2 days that we're here. And I'll probably do a sob story on that in the next video when we're stood in front of it. We'll definitely be coming back to do like Alcatraz and stuff like that. And hopefully tomorrow we'll get to the Golden Gate Bridge.
Yeah.
But today, we're still going to wander around and do stuff. Okay, let's go and grab a beverage.
Beveragina.
A lovely beverage from tourist favourite Hard Rock Cafe. I can hear them calling us. I was so zoomed in. Sea lions? They love fighting. Just the speed, it's freaking all the pelicans out. They just Tokyo drift the way out of the port. Well, look at them. They're all getting waved around.
Oh, no.
Hello, Georgia. What are we going to do next?
We are going on a sunset tour of the San Francisco Bay.
Yeah, that's exciting. It's only about $20 each, so that's fun. And apparently we'll see some views of Alcatraz and the Golden Gate Bridge.
And the sea lions.
Yeah. Good morning. Welcome to our last day in San Francisco. Come back.
Yeah.
All we've done this morning is check out of our hotel and come to the Bay Street shopping area. Grabbed a coffee,
and I'm doing a short walk somewhere pretty exciting that we will show you right now. Ooh. We came to Pixar. We're not going in.
No, we're not going.
No, we just wanted to come see it. That's so cool. Very excited. There's a big seagull from Finding Nemo on the roof, and you probably can't see. Not really, no, but straight through there you can kind of make out the Pixar ball in front of the Steve Jobs building. I think it's like there. So obviously we couldn't do anything at Pixar, but it was nice just to go see it. And we'll try and break in another time. with their permission. But now we're going to go back to the Bay Street shopping area, have a look around. A couple stores, get something to eat, and then we're going over to Lucasfilm and have a look at Lucasfilm. Not that we can do much there either, but they have a Yoda statue.
Woo!
So we've done a little bit of shopping next to the construction that's going on, and now we're on Shake Shack for lunch. Yay! Party, party, food, dance.
You said that was cheating yesterday.
So here we are. We made it to the highlight of the trip that is closed. But it just means we're gonna have to come back. But we're gonna peek through the windows. Yeah. Until next time. Mm-hmm. Let's go look at Lucasfilm studio, which is just right around the corner from here. Let's go check that out. Lovely scenic walk over to Lucasfilm, which I believe is this building right here. That's where Star Wars is from. Star Wars. Here we are. The Lucasfilm buildings. What did you see in one of the windows?
A porg.
A porg. So yeah, we're definitely in the right place. Yep, there was a stormtrooper-y looking thing in that window. So it was actually very cool. You could actually go into the lobby. They do have to tell you no filming, and they have a few rules, which is obviously okay. But yeah, no, some really cool like artifacts, some little statues of characters and things.
Mm-hmm.
It was just a nice room as well, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was very nice. Yeah. Lovely place to walk, I'm sure.
Yeah, definitely. Now, I don't know what we're going to do. There is a Starbucks here, which of course we always end up at a Starbucks, but we'll have a little stroll through the park, and then we're going to go and try and see if we can see the Golden Gate Bridge.
Woo!
Okay, the decision has been made. We're going to go to the Lucasfilm Starbucks. Just for the sake of going to the Lucasfilm Starbucks. Thank you.
are leaving San Francisco. Had a wonderful time.
Yeah, it's been great. We just needed more time, as yeah, with everywhere else.
So much more time.
But it's been great to come and see it and like visit it for the first time and stuff.
And now we're heading further north in California, and we're going to be doing Redwood National Park tomorrow. So
yeah, that'll be fun. And then we're going up the Oregon coast, which everyone in
the world
everyone says is going to be amazing. So
yeah.
Yeah, very much looking forward to that.
Obviously, the first stop of the day is at Starbucks. Good morning.
Good morning.
Hey, stranger. So here we are at what we believe is called the Grove of Titans, as there are some ginormous trees here. And Georgia is in a bush.
This isn't sort of a very used trail.
No, we should probably go back. Would you like to tell me a fun fact?
In the deep forest, you'll see secondary trunks called reiterations sprouting from the main redwood trunk. These are exact clones of the main tree, and they often grow when the main tree's crown or branches have been damaged.
Interesting.
As you walk the trail, you'll be surrounded by huckleberries and hemlocks, ferns and sorrels. This dense blanket of plants contributes to the high amount of carbon in these forests that they take in and store.
So here we are, Redwood National Park, state park, forest. It seems to have a few names. We called it a national park. We were on our way to the Grove of Titans, but it's actually a lot further away than we expected, and we've got like an 8-hour drive today, so we won't be able to go there. But look at the size of some of these trees. Like, I know we've already shown some of them, but like, these are insane. And they're like as wide as a little car. And would you like to share with the good people what we have in store?
Share with the group.
Share with the group.
Well, today for show and tell, we have a lovely Redwood National Park sticker.
Yay!
And here you can see
some of the rings.
The rings of a redwood.
Yeah.
Educational.
As with our other locations, the sticker will now be available on Etsy. You can go get it from there. Supporting by buying a sticker supports us doing things like this, so get buying.
So we did continue a little bit of a hike, but I don't know. I just wanted to say that we continued and we weren't lazy and getting 10 feet in and we're like, done. So we did continue a little bit on the walk just to see a few more of the trees, a few more scenic views. We are heading back to the car now. So we do have an 8-hour drive and both of us need to pee.
Yeah, and we've got like the entirety of the Oregon coast to drive today.
We've got to get out of California and drive the entire length of Oregon, basically.
That's what I just said.
I'll push you off this cliff.
Yeah, we've got a very long drive. Most people will do the Oregon coast as its own trip and we're going to just go brum, and see
it
in a day.
We'll do it in 8 hours, it'll be fine.
Yeah. We are staying on the coast though, and in the morning we're going to get to do a bit of coast things too before we go to Portland. So stay tuned and we will show you what we see.
That one's like
a different
colour.
Yeah.
Not as tree coloured.
Yeah.
So we are now officially in the Grand State of Oregon.
The Grand State.
Welcome to the Oregon coast.
Thank
you. This is Oregon looking very much Oregony.
Yeah.
We do have a lovely ocean view over here. The waves are very angry.
So angry.
And we already have like salt on the car windows. You can't see it.
Yeah.
But
yeah, we do.
It's been a somewhat scenic drive so far. That zoomed in. We have had a lot of scenic drives along the highway with the ocean on the left, but then we also have gone into quite a few like little towns here in Oregon.
Yeah.
That are just kind of, you know, the kind of towns that you like, it was a small town, everyone knew everyone, nothing bad ever happened. And then, like, 12 people get massacred. Yeah. That kind of town.
I guess you could say that, yeah.
Yeah. But, yeah. I mean, the rest of the drive has been pretty.
Yeah.
So, no complaints. We've got 2.5 hours left. Somehow. And, yeah, somehow. But,
yeah.
Here's the view. Ooh.
Hey strangers, good morning from the Oregon coast. We've just checked out of our Airbnb and about to go to Grumpy's Cafe for something to eat. We'll show you a little bit about the Airbnb right now.
Oh, hi Jake. I was just about to head out, but I can show you around real quick. So this is my Oregon coast beachfront Airbnb. Here you can see the bedroom. Over here we have the office. Here we have the living room. Kitchen. Bathroom / kitchen sink. And the bathroom. Where we stayed last night on the Oregon coast, staying in like a little beach bungalow, and the beach is literally right behind us. So our lovely host Dallas did provide some beach towels for us to use. He's also made out a little guide to the Airbnb, which is super sweet. The place has Wi-Fi, TV, a lot of outlets, which has been really great because Jake had to finish up some editing last night. And then just behind, got a microwave, coffee machine, toaster, mugs, and party cups. So if you'd be interested in staying in this beachfront property on the Oregon coast, we'll leave the link in the description below. And now we're going to go get some breakfast.
Bon appetit. Grumpy's breakfast.
Delicious.
It was lovely. Yeah, it was reasonably priced.
Yeah.
And it was very good.
If you're in Rockaway Beach on the Oregon coast at any time, go see Grumpy's.
There you go. The little blue building. Now we're going to have a look around some of the little stores on the front, and then we're heading up to Cannon Beach.
Yes. So we've got our iced coffee, and we're just gonna do a little bit more exploring of Rockaway Beach, and then
yeah,
we'll see what weird and quirky shops we wander into. Everyone that we encountered was really nice, and everything that
we looked at or bought or think about buying, was all very reasonably priced. I did buy this hat. It's windy and cold and I didn't bring one on the trip. But this was only $16. So,
yeah, we don't think about it in Canadian though.
No, never think about it in Canadian. If you think about it in pounds, it was probably about a tenner. So, that's fine. If you think about it in Canadian, it's a mortgage. But we are now on our way to Cannon Beach, which is about 35 minutes away, and we will show you the drive and show you what it's like when we get there.
So here we are, we've made it to Cannon Beach, and we're just about to, ooh, I fell down a hole. We're about to go see Haystack Rock.
Big old rock.
Big old rock. There it is. Found a moon jelly.
Jelly! Don't touch it.
Yeah, I think it's a moon jelly. You can technically touch them on the squidgy part. I just can't tell if that's the squidgy part or if it's upside down.
I think it's upside down.
Yeah, I think that's normally how they land. They might be non-stinky completely, but I wouldn't know. Okay, gonna try and use the tiny microphone. We've called it affectionately mini mic. So Georgia. We're at a different location of our road trip.
We are indeed, Jake.
And what do we normally do when we're in a cool location on the road trip?
We release a new sticker.
A new sticker, you
a
say?
A new sticker, that's what I do say.
That probably means that we have a new sticker for the Oregon coast.
No way.
Oh, wait, what's that in your hand?
What? Look at this rare seashell I just found. Whoa, it's a heavy one.
I don't know what's going on. The Oregon coast sticker, woo! Yay. So, as with all of our other location stickers, it's now available on Etsy, so go check it out, link in the description, probably.
And then this one's my favourite.
This one's a good one. And we hand drew it, this was a team effort, this one. And yeah, it's kind of just inspired by the Oregon
run away,
coast.
Dear.
Oh dear,
run away,
I'm going to get attacked by a wave. So yeah, there it is. It's available now on Etsy. And every sticker that you buy supports our adventures or gets us a coffee. So
yeah.
Go and check out everything that's linked in the description.
Yay! So we are now leaving Cannon Beach. We got to see Haystack Rock, which I'm sure Jake got plenty of footage of. Yes. I was frolicking in the ocean.
You were off in your own ocean world.
I was living my best life. But now we are heading to where we will be staying tonight, which is going to be Portland.
Yay.
We're going to explore the city a little bit. We don't actually have a plan for Portland for today.
No.
But we do have one for tomorrow, so make sure you stick around to see that. But yeah, come along with us to Portland.
Let's go see what's going on in the weird place that is Portland.
Keep Portland weird.
That's what they say.
It's the literal slogan.
So we just arrived in Portland.
There's some flat-back plants. Oh!
Plants. Oh! That's a bit better. We just got to Portland and checked into our hotel. We've just left to wander the streets. We've just seen Jake's Grill, which is a fancy steak restaurant. So we won't go there. But we're going to go into Target and kind of just aimlessly roam around. We've got more time in Portland than we expected.
Yeah.
So the plans are all tomorrow. Today is just...
wander around.
See what Portland has to offer. Oh, Starbucks! Hello, we just got to this square. There's a load of food trucks, which is nice. We're gonna go check out Starbucks, see if they have the Oregon mug, because it's awaiting to be added to our collection.
Yeah.
Made our way into a place called the Punch Bowl in Portland. There's 3,200 square feet of games and eating and drinking, so...
What a great day.
What a great day, and apparently there's bowling too.
It got so dark so fast. I was about to film Georgia, and now this is all you can see.
Right, she's lit it up for me. This is our punch bowl that we got, the tiki something or other. Well, it's a big punch bowl, and you can get it for four people, or for eight people, or
this
just as individual glasses.
People, I don't think this would serve four, but...
We'll see. They give you a little glass each, and the fun thing is that they don't match. That's quirky. And then you get a big ladle, and the drink. So we'll let you know how it is. So we got some chicken quesadillas, there's the punch bowl, and this like pull apart brioche garlicky goodness with a marinara sauce. Ready for snacks later as well. Of course! Not that I can see you at all, but now it's time for a sporting game of Connect Four. Oh, this is so dark. Ooh. So we just finished up the games of Connect Four. Georgia unfortunately did lose every single game, and that's okay. We're done at Punch Bowl. It was good, wasn't it? Yeah, whatever. It was good. It was a really fun time. The food was pretty decent. The drinks were fun. And they had games everywhere. They had bowling and some of the like things you just paid for. But no, nice time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I think we're close to probably calling it a night, even though it's early. Just because... Yeah, we got up early and...
We've got a big day tomorrow.
It's very dark outside. We don't know where we are. We don't know where... we shouldn't go.
So
we'll probably call it, go watch a movie or something like that, and we've got some exciting stuff for tomorrow. Good morning, strangers.
Good morning.
Welcome to the beautiful city of Portland. Here in Oregon, we've grabbed our Starbucks, we've checked out of the hotel, we've packed up the car. We're now on a lovely stroll.
We are.
To Aviation Gin, Ryan Reynolds' gin company.
I hope he's there.
I hope he's there. And we're going to go and do a little gin tasting and a gin tour. And probably...
At midday.
And probably buy clothes. But that's where we're going to start today. The rest of the day is filled with a couple of the random things of just exploring Portland.
Mm-hmm.
And we shall see where this takes us. So we just arrived. It does look like they might be having some sort of event on at some point, but we're here for our tour. We got here just before they open, but then they also open at the exact time that our tour starts, so I don't know what we're supposed to do. Mr. Reynolds?
As far as celebrity bosses go, he's a pretty good one to have. He didn't get involved in aviation to change it and make it all about himself.
Hello and welcome to my office. I'm a greedy person, but I feel the portrait more accurately captures me than the actual me. Now for the next 15 minutes, I'm afraid I'm going to need your help. I say that as if I'm asking. The doors have been locked, and we've impounded your car, bus, or scooter. Anyway, it turns out my evil twin brother, Gordon Reynolds, has signed a contract for me to appear in Green Lantern 2. Thanks a lot, DocuSign. Well, I don't think I have to tell anyone here why we must stop this from happening at all costs. Now, somewhere in this room is the contract. It was hidden by Gordon, who is fiendishly clever, so it will take some pretty good sleuthing to find it. The studio executives are on their way to pick it up, so please help me, Aviation Gin Tour Group. You're my only hope. I know. Different movie. Forget about that. Get to work.
Magic code, which is in my head. Thank you guys. You can let go. Gets entered. Right. So now we're putting in. You're going to hear a magical click, and that means that we did a job right. We have to be really, really quiet to hear it. Ready?
Wow.
Did you guys hear that? Magic is real.
Okay. Cinematic mode enabled. We're on the phone because the camera is being difficult.
Yeah.
Hello, Georgia.
Hello.
Okay. We've got the flights, $36 with tip, so $15 each, whatever. We can't remember what we got exactly.
I know that I got the blackbird, which is aviation gin, blackberry, lime juice, and jalapeno simple syrup.
I think that's the pink one.
I would assume it is this one. I also got the boat, which is aviation gin, of course, Krogstad aquavit, a bit of raspberry syrup and lemon juice.
Nice.
I would assume it's this one.
I believe it is because we both got the same.
Yes. And then I also got the Jupiter, which again is aviation gin, guava, grapefruit juice, lemon juice, tamarind, and local phalaenum.
Phalaenum. Okay. I also got the boat. I then got the...
You got the Jim Jim Mule.
Jim Mule, that's it. And then this one was the bottom one.
The Oasis.
The Oasis, that's the one. Yeah. Very nice. We'll try these. Hopefully the camera will do whatever it's going to do. We'll be fine. We'll be fine. We're almost done anyway. And we also made a decent purchase. So we finished off at aviation, made our way to Life of Pi Pizza. So we'll see how this goes.
This was something that I was googling last night, the best pizza in Portland, and this was one of the options, and then we just so happened to stumble across it. So.
Yeah, here we are.
Win-win.
Bon appetit. We enjoyed that lovely lunch at Life of Pi.
Life of Pi.
It was very nice. We are now going to a location that Georgia does not know where we are, so... That should be fun. We'll go there. And then we're going to walk around to Voodoo Donuts, which is based in Portland. We'll go have a snack.
Portland.
Made our way to Salt... Nice. Salt and Straw, which is a quirky ice cream place we first heard about at Disneyland. Then we tried in Seattle.
Yeah.
And here we are in Portland. Quirkiness.
So we've got our ice creams. I got the malted, salted, caramel cookie dough concoction.
Yeah.
And Jake...
gooey brownie something or other.
Both equally delicious.
Yes.
We're
just walking down some of these cute streets and we're going to go down towards the river probably.
To Voodoo Donuts because we need... Second dessert.
Of course.
Obviously. We didn't have breakfast today, so...
This, ice cream it is.
This is it.
And gin.
And gin. We had gin for breakfast, pizza for lunch, and ice cream and donuts for dessert. Health.
So after some sketchy situations, to say the least, we had to left and right quite a lot to get down here. Made it to the river. So we're going to have a little look around the riverfront and then probably just make our way back up to the car, I think. Hello, Georgia.
Hello, Jake.
Fancy meeting you here in Portland, Oregon.
Portland, Oregon.
And you know, because we're in Portland, Oregon, Georgia.
We're in Portland, Oregon.
That normally means that, like, because we've arrived somewhere, that we have something to share with the people.
We do, usually.
Usually. I think we do here too, don't we? It might be perhaps in your hand.
I don't know what you're talking about.
No? Oh.
Maybe it's this.
Oh, maybe. Is it perhaps the Portland, Oregon Keep Portland Weird sticker? I think it is. Ooh, got attacked by a leaf while we showed off. Yeah, it's the Portland sticker. Yay! Cool. And where can people buy it from?
Etsy.
Yeah. And do you know what happens when they buy it?
It helps us.
Helps us out, yeah. Which is nice. So, yeah.
Lovely.
And along with all the other stickers, it's now available on Etsy. So go check it out if you would like a little travel sticker from Portland. And Georgia drew this one pretty much all herself. And it's really, really
great.
It's really great. So yeah, go check it out. Yay! We found it.
Found it.
It was only like a couple blocks off the river. That's quite the line. So we have actually been to Voodoo Donuts at Universal in Orlando.
We'll get one then.
We'll get one there.
In December.
You can mobile order it.
Yeah.
I'm sure it's cool. And it's cool that we've seen it though. And if you are in town, check it out.
So we are now leaving Portland.
We are.
We are on our way to Washington. We're just going to be staying just outside of Seattle. We're not going into Seattle tomorrow. We're just going to drive straight up to Vancouver. We're going to see some Jake's parents.
Yeah.
We have been to Seattle, so if you would like to see those videos, they are on our channel.
Link in the description, link, pop out in the corner.
Yeah.
All the things.
So yeah, I mean, technically this is the end now of our US road trip.
Yeah, we'll probably film bits in Vancouver, but it'll probably just be like one video across the 3 days.
Yeah,
just because, yeah, we're spending time with mom and dad.
Okay, hello. We are in Vancouver, British Columbia. We're about to leave Vancouver, British Columbia.
And drive back to Kelowna.
Kelowna, BC. We've had an absolutely amazing trip. It's been incredible. We've had the best time. We spent the last few days with my parents, so we haven't filmed anything. We will be back in Vancouver at some point. We have never filmed in Vancouver, even though we've been like 3 times now.
Yeah.
We just wanted to say thank you so much for watching the video. We hope you enjoyed all the videos if you watched them. Thank you for all the new subscribers and likes and views and comments and everything else. And please just continue checking things out.
Yeah.
We've got loads of videos on the way.
Next adventure is going to be Disney World at Christmas.
Yeah, which is like 12 weeks away for us right now, but it might be happening as we post this video. I don't really know. So they'll be coming soon probably. But yeah, we just want to say thank you so much for watching along. Please go check out all our Instagrams, our blog posts and everything else, as well as the Steamboat style merchandise and just everything else that we have going on, because there's always going to be something.
There's always something.
Thank you very much again. And we'll see you in the next one.
Bye. Woo.